In the crowded hallways of Issaquah High School, there is simply no reason to notice young Tutor Magda and Ben Alexander. They are simply two friends at a redundant stage of life. Just like you and I, they spend their breaks between classes talking amongst each other about things that will prove unimportant in the near future. Just your average teenagers. That is, until they're in the weight room.
So I haven't actually had Ben in class, but I know him and Tutor are equal caliber athletes. They've been trained the same way. Having Tutor in my CrossFit class has been pretty amazing. I can always count on him to be a demo when I'm having someone show cleans or squats or whatever. He is just my live action person that I can go to. My technique isn't always great, but his is always spot on. It's been a fun experience, I think, for me and for the kids in class to have an athlete of that level here with us every day.
What's the relationship between you two at this point?
Yeah, we're pretty good gym buddies. We always work out together and push each other, and we're pretty friendly.
A simple relationship, but it's taken them to a level that even they didn't imagine possible. Meet Ben Alexander. He had been playing football at a young age when he learned about CrossFit in the fourth grade. By age 13, he decided to quit football and make CrossFit his full-time program.
What does CrossFit have that football doesn't to you? What's the big difference?
Well, when you go into a CrossFit gym, you have actual certified coaches that know what they're doing, and they can show you good form.
But you didn't maybe want to take what you learned at that gym and apply it to football and maybe continue with football? Or?
Well, I actually did, because I started CrossFit in fourth grade for football training. So I took what I learned in the gym and I did apply it to football, and it made me stronger. But in seventh grade, I just realized it was too much of a time commitment.
Being 24th internationally, Ben focuses most of his time on his strength.
I'm probably the best at either the snatch too, or back squat or front squat.
How much can you do for a snatch?
170.
Despite him saying 170, he managed to get 175 right on camera. Tutor Magda had been playing soccer for quite some time when his dad decided to take him to the gym at age 9. By age 10, he decided soccer was a thing of the past.
When did you really start officially working out?
So officially training was, I started when they announced that they were gonna have a teenager division at the CrossFit Games. And so I was just like, okay, let's start training for this. Let's try to get to the games.
To you, what was your first success? I've done it.
I didn't know I could rank this high in international. So I guess this year was my first realization that okay, I'm pretty good at this. I can
What Tutor speaks of is known as the CrossFit Games, an international CrossFit tournament that the youngsters decided to take on themselves. Only the top 20 would qualify for finals. They had quite a journey ahead of them.
Well, there were two parts to it. So there was the CrossFit Open, which is an international competition where everyone around the world can compete, and there's different divisions. So Tutor and I were in the 14, 15-year-old division.
It was at these games their strength, endurance, and minds would be tested, and perhaps they weren't ready for it. Though Tutor managed to achieve third place, Ben only made it to 24th. And therefore, could not move on to the next round.
Ben, not qualifying for that. What was that like? Seeing the news.
It was really hard, actually. You have to get into the top 20 in the world to make it to the games. And since I got 24th, knowing I was four places away, knowing if I did maybe three more reps in a workout, or if I did 30 seconds better, that I could have made it to the games. That just crushed me. It took me a little bit to get back into the gym and try to push myself, knowing I want to make it to the games next year.